the Mets. Meet the Mets. Step right up and greet the Mets. Hello, everybody. The Lawn Gnome is here.
What's he done? Everything.
So I went to see a very early morning showing of a film thanks to the film critics community I never would have known existed until it was too late, thanks to a great teaser trailer that I saw in the summer. It stars a gentleman in the acting community that a lot of us felt had kind of fallen from grace and were just waiting for a true comeback performance of his, and I think we may have gotten this. And of course we're talking about Johnny Depp in the Scott Cooper-directed film Black Mass. It is the story of the notorious South Boston leader of the Winter Hill Gang, known as James Whitey Bulger, and how he paired up with John Connolly, an old South Boston schoolmate of his, who is in the FBI, wants to use Whitey Bulger as an informant, not only for the purposes of catching the Italian mafia from North Boston, but also to sort of put himself into the ranks of Irish mob royalty and also get protection. But we always have to remember that when it comes to working with criminals, especially the ones who have a true brain in their head, sometimes the player can get played. Because James Bulger believed that since he was going to be an FBI informant to his old friend, he realized that he could probably get away with everything under the sun in the world of crime. And of course, he had a whole bunch of people involved, and a whole bunch of people on the FBI side were trying to get involved in bringing him down because they kind of felt that he was not doing what he was supposed to do. Rather, he was just taking advantage and making the FBI a joke. And the craziest part is the fact that there is also a brother of Whitey Bulger, a state senator of Massachusetts that is played by Benedict Cumberbatch, his brother William Bulger, who everyone thought had a connection with this, but the fact that the two of them were on two separate sides of the spectrum, how they didn't seem to be involved at all. This movie was very well directed and executed. There are so many great actors and actresses involved in this movie, and I'm just going to read a whole bunch off of my computer because there is no way that I'm going to remember all of these great names. We had Joel Edgerton, who plays John Connolly, the FBI agent who signs Whitey Bulger up, and he has been showing his true colors and spread his wings in the world of acting thanks to another movie he made earlier this year called The Gift, and he did a great job. Benedict Cumberbatch was probably one of the few things in the film that I was not too happy about, because we think Benedict Cumberbatch, we think everything from Sherlock to The Imitation Game, and I really was expecting a lot more from his performance. Was it bad? Not at all, but he did a decent job, just something that I would have expected better from a great name like Benedict Cumberbatch. Dakota Johnson from 50 Shades of Grey, while she has a minor role, she also did a great job. Kevin Bacon, you can't go wrong with Kevin Bacon. Peter Skarsgård, Jesse Plemons from Breaking Bad, David Harbour from The Newsroom, Adam Scott, Corey Stahl from Ant-Man, and even Juno Temple has a small role in this film. It was a very gripping story, I will definitely say. I was on the edge of my seat, especially when Johnny Depp is on screen. This could be his Oscar-winning performance, everybody. He has done so much in his time in Hollywood, but I will say that him in Black Mass playing James Whitey Bulger was the best thing I've ever seen him do in all of his acting, and I have seen some great acting from him. Everybody else, good, bad, or indifferent, all played their roles very well, and it was definitely a very interesting look when it comes to mob movies. Mob movies are things that I absolutely love because I am a big history nut, and my fiancé is a history teacher, but one of the few things that I always say that I appreciate is the fact that I like to see the dark points of American history, or even world history, be told. Because you don't really learn much about the mafia and other notorious gangs in school in history class. So to actually see the underbelly of American history, in my case, take shape, is definitely something cool to see. And I will say one thing. I would never have wanted to meet James Bulger, because not only was this guy a notorious criminal, this guy meant business, and he took crap from nobody, and the guy was also somewhat paranoid, because every single time someone apparently spoke, well, we all know what happened there. And that's one of the few faults that I felt with this movie. Along with Benedict Cumberbatch's decent performance, I felt that the movie was far too predictable. You knew who was going to die. The minute they came on screen, you said, okay, that one's gonna die, that guy's gonna die, this girl's gonna die. We all could tell who was going to live and who was going to die. And the other thing that I kind of felt was not so great about the movie is, while it was very good and very gripping and definitely very entertaining, I found myself yawning a couple of times because I just felt it was going a little too long. I just feel that the execution was not entirely perfect, because when you take a look at mob movies and you want to think about great ones, I think of movies like The Untouchables, The Godfather, and Goodfellas and Casino and all of that stuff. This one definitely goes up there with some of the best mob movies of all time, and I will say one thing as far as Johnny Depp's case, it's a hell of a lot better than Public Enemies. I would say that if you want to see Johnny Depp in probably his greatest role, you should see Black Mass in theaters. I'm still debating on whether or not I want to actually get this film on DVD, and I know that there's some other great mob movies on the way this year, especially Legend, which I'm really excited for, starring Tom Hardy. Don't know when it's coming out in theaters, but I definitely will be seeing this movie. So, yeah, Black Mass is a very good movie. Not the best, but definitely one of the better ones that I have seen this year, and I am going to be giving Black Mass 3 out of 4. So thank you very much for watching, everybody. Looking forward to giving you guys another movie review, and I will see you in the next one. Actions speak louder than words.